Hi, thank you very much, everyone, for coming for this event. I'm Makoto Abe, business advisor for the Fukuoka government of Japan. I think we are running a little late, so I think we're going to get going with this. First of all, I believe Mr. Matsumoto will talk a little bit about the Ruby 1.9, I believe.
Actually, I'm not going to talk about 1.9, and I just arrived here, so my flight arrived 1 hour ago, about two hours ago. So I'm kind of, my brain is screwed up. So I just give a short presentation about the languages, programming languages, and I will accept the questions. So if you have any questions, so wait until my short presentation. So I'm going to talk about the language matter. So the world is driven by computers. Like Google has a huge number of computers, and everyone has personal computers, and even the kids in the elementary school use computers. Computers becomes more and more important these days. But most people just use computers. They don't love computers, unlike us, right? And the computers are mere tools for them. So my children is, my oldest children is going to high schools, and they use computers just to watch the YouTube videos and search Wikipedia for their reports. And I don't think they love computers. But the few people love computers. And that people will change the world. So mere users don't change the world. We do. So we are kind of privileged people. And language matters. Programming language is very important for us. So every software is written in some kind of language, even assemblers, or C, C++, Java, or Python, or Ruby. And computers don't work without software. So to write a software, we need to write them in programming language so in directory, the programming language is very important. But few love programming language. The most programmers just use languages. You know, it's programming language given. Most of us don't design the programming language. So the most programmers have something they want to do with the computers. So they have something what to do by programming. But there are very few people who screwed up the purpose and the means, the programming language is the merely a mean or tools, but some people who really, really love tool and even create one. So I'm one of them. Now, that few people change the world. Language help programmers to think. And the language give inspiration to programmers. When I was very young, I started programming in BASIC, and that language didn't tell me about recursion and the structures programming. But after that, I started learning about the Pascal, who is instinct language. The Pascal taught me about the recursion and the structured programming, and I was enlightened by the language. After that, I learned C and Lisp and Smalltalk and a lot of languages, and I started to love language. But every language I learned, that taught me something new. Then, so language, even though I done programming in Pascal for 20-30 years, but the things I learned from Pascal is still living inside of me. So learning language and the language itself enlighten programmers, and the language affect productivity. So I love all languages. I'm language geek. I'm language lovers. So I love Ruby, of course, and I love Python. I love Java. I love C++. Even though I have bad memory with C++. And I want everyone feels happy with languages. So some people had some kind of trouble or grief through the programming language. Yeah. And I want to reduce these kind of the bad impression about the programming language. I want to be part of a better world via programming language. So providing better programming language to make the world better. So I don't want people feeling grieved by languages. So, but I don't think I can change the Java language or the Python language. So I changed the Ruby language to make world better place. So I will polish my language. So, and these people working behind the other language will do similar things, I hope. And I will encourage others to choose better languages or make existing one better or create one, new one. That's Golux. What is your name? So as a conclusion, code Ruby, be happy. Or whatever language you choose, be happy. And that's all for my short presentation. And as coach here, who is who is responsible for the 1.9 VM, we have translator here. So ask coach about 1.9 internals. And if you have any question about 1.9 release plan, so the release manager Yugui will coming to the RubyConf. So ask her about the releases, not me. And any other question, I will answer. So thank you for listening.
もしまとめた方が良ければまとめて日本語で今伝えてもらっても良いでしょうか。あの今の松本さんの英語のスピーチでしたけれど、用紙だけもし申し上げた方が良ければいたしますが、どうしますか。大丈夫ですか、皆さん。
日本語で聞きたい人、はい。はい、手を挙げてください。あ、大丈夫ですね。はい。OK。ありがとうございます。Any questions?
質問はもし日本語でしたら英語の方に通訳いたしますので、大丈夫です。Go
ahead. I use Ruby, so I want it be faster if possible, but it's not my primary goal. Just because I'm a language designer, and the making fast language is my first priority, but still, so no one complain about the faster language. So I will do, and he will do actually.
自分がRubyを使ってらっしゃらないので、Rubyを非常に高速な言語にするっていうのはあまり構わないのかっていうような質問なんですけど、いや、そんなことはなくて、私もRuby使ってますし、早くしたいというふうに思ってる。ただそれがその第一番目のゴールではありません、ということです。でも、高速な言語についてはもう文句言う人はいないから、早くしたいと思うけれども、ただそれが単に最優先順位の一番上にあることではないということだけです、ということです。
Yes.
What do you think is still causing people grief with Ruby? Like, what do you still want to improve?
Ruby で何か人が悲しんでることがあるとすれば、それは何だと思いますか？どういうところを改善したいと思ってらっしゃいますか？
Well, I don't think the people who choose Ruby voluntarily is not suffering about the language, but you know, the rules comes in and you know.There are some people who were forced to use Ruby, even though they don't love, don't like the language. So some people just don't like Ruby language. You know, there's something like the dog people and cat people in the programming language too. So like a Python people and Ruby people. So some Python or scheme people, they're forced to use Ruby, so they feel some kind of grief.And I don't think I can do anything about that. But still, so when someone needs to use Ruby in very huge project, like 100 people teams or very complex software, like millions of lines code, so they sometimes feel some kind of grief. So like the one can modify the core language very easily in Ruby. So I'm vaguely planning about the some kind of the modularizing the namespace, so that one can isolate his changes into this some kind of the namespace or module. So that's kind of my big plan for Ruby 2.0.
その Ruby を選んで好んで使っている人はそんなに悲しむということはないと思うんですけれども、強制的にというか無理やり使えと、自分はその Ruby タイプの言語は好まないのに使えというふうになると、やはりそれは悲しいということがあるかもしれない。人に犬型猫型っていうような好みがあるのと同じように、例えば Python がすごく好きだと、スキーム型の人が Ruby を使えというふうに無理やり言われたら、それはその悲しいということになるかもしれませんと。あるいは Ruby を非常に大きな、例えば100人ぐらいのチームでの何かコーディングをするようなプロジェクトに使わされると、あるいは非常に複雑なソフトで何百万行とかいうコードに使うということになると、やはりその使いにくいというか、その嫌かもしれない。で、なんか買いやすいんですか、こうところが
そうそう
あるので、今考えているのはモジュール化してネームスペースとかっていうのをこう作って、その中でのコードの変更が他のところに影響しないような形にモジュール化するようなことを考えてますということです。
Man, she's good.
Thank you.
is Ruby changing as quickly as you would like it to?
Matsumoto-san が望んでるようなスピードで Ruby はどんどん変わってるか。Your question is whether Ruby is changing as fast as he'd like. Is that right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think so.Yeah, Ruby, the change of Ruby is very slow, but you know, that's because my brain is slow.
Change はちょっとゆっくりかもしれませんけど、それは私の脳がゆっくりだからだと思うと、スローだからだ。
はい、じゃあ。Thank you.